Good morning, everyone. I hope that you're well today and that you're keeping fit and healthy and that you're enjoying getting out in the sunshine when it comes. Today is a special day. It's Sunday the 14th of June, and today is the last day of SML of this year. This is the day that if we were together, we would be saying well done for listening to all the stories and answering all the questions and the quizzes. And we still want to do that online. We want to say thank you for listening so well and for all the fun. We've had a ball this year in SML, and I think we've all learnt a lot. So well done. In the church services that we've been listening to online, that Angus has been preaching in, we've been studying the book of Philippians. And what I like to do when we're studying a book in church is I like to read the book through so that I'm a bit more prepared for the service. Philippians is quite a short book, it's only four chapters, and so it's quite easy to read it over and over. There's some verses in chapter 4, and every time I get to them, they're so amazing that I read them twice. And I wanted to share them with you this morning, and guess what? I'm going to read them twice. So listen up, this is Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Just listen to that again. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Verse 6 says about thanksgiving, and we have so much to be thankful for. When the lockdown began, we didn't know that we'd be able to stay together online and learn and do quizzes and craft and things like that. And I'm so grateful to God for the technology and for people who know how to work the technology that we can do all of this. We have so much to give thanks for, and I'm sure that you do as well. So when we pray in a couple of moments' time, I'm going to leave some little gaps, and I want you to fill them in your head, things that you're thankful for in your life. It also says, do not be anxious about anything. And there's lots of uncertainties at the moment. We don't know when we'll be able to meet together again in SML or in church, or even when you're going to start school again. But God knows, and I'm so thankful for that. So if you have any worries, I'm going to leave a little gap for that too. And you feel free to fill in the gaps in your mind as we pray. So let's put our hands together and let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for your word. Thank you for this time together, for all the SML videos and church videos that we've been able to learn from while we've been in lockdown. Thank you for Angus and for the leadership of the church, for Kim and for the SML leaders, for keeping all of it going. We pray that you would be with them and give them the strength they need. We thank you for our families and for the extra time that we're able to spend with them. We pray that you continue to give us patience when we need it. Heavenly Father, you know what we're thankful for in our own hearts. Father God, again we give you thanks for the key workers, for those in the NHS, that are working so hard to keep us all safe. We pray you would give them rest when they need it and strength when they need it. Heavenly Father, we pray for the things that we're worried about and the things that we're unsure about. We thank you that you know what lies ahead of us. And so anything that's little or big that's on our hearts, we give it to you now. Thank you, God, that you hear our prayers. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, in SML, over the last few weeks, we have been learning about Paul. And last week, we finished our series on Paul. And he was a missionary, and he went out across the world to spread the good news of Jesus. We also learnt that we can spread the good news of Jesus from right where we are. And so we're going to sing a song together before we go to Kim for our last story this morning. We're going to sing I'm Ready to Go. And I know that we're still in lockdown and I know we can't go far, but we're ready to go and we can spread the good news where we are. So I'm going to get my little helpers and then we'll sing together.
Boys and girls, I wonder if you like going into the sea. Can you see what they're doing in this picture? Make it a little bit bigger for you. So they are surfing, but there is a sign and they have ignored the warning on the sign. So here we go. The sign says danger, strong current. Wonder if you've ever ignored a warning, maybe something your mum and dad have said and you've just gone on ahead anyway and done it, or maybe something your teacher has said. Well, it was a bit like that for the people in Noah's day. God was very sad because the people were doing what they wanted. They had forgotten all about God and his laws, and everybody was doing what they thought was right, except for Noah. And God spoke to Noah, and God said to Noah, Noah, I am going to send a flood to destroy the whole world. And the only people who are going to be saved from this flood are the people who are going to be on the ark. And Noah, I want you to build an ark. You see, boys and girls, Noah was different from everybody else. Noah loved God. The Bible says that Noah walked with God, that he was a righteous man. That meant that he did what God wanted. He did what was right in God's eyes. So Noah was very old, but still God wanted him to do this, to build the ark. So he started. You can see on this, God gave Noah very precise measurements, And if I can show you, if you can picture in your head the length of a football pitch, well, the ark was 1.5 times that. So it was absolutely huge. And they didn't have all the machinery that we have nowadays. Noah and his sons, three sons, started to build. And they built for years and years and years. God had said 120 years, that was going to be the time. And after that, he was going to send the flood to punish the world and to punish those who hadn't listened. So as well as being a builder, Noah was also a missionary. Do you remember what a missionary is? Yes. So that is somebody who tells others about God. And remember, you don't need to go away to the other side of the world. You can do it right where you live. You can tell others in your family and others in your friendship group all about God. Well, Noah told the people about God as they were building. And if you can see in the picture, they're laughing. And they were probably saying, you silly old fool, God is not going to destroy the world. In fact, Noah, you've got it all wrong. And they didn't listen. But Noah continued to be faithful to God, to do what God wanted. And day after day, he told the people that if they didn't come onto the ark, that they were going to be lost in the great flood that God was sending. God said to Noah, as well as building the ark, Noah, I want you to bring animals onto the ark. Two of every kind of animal. And some animals, I want you to bring seven pairs because they were different special animals. So Noah waited and something amazing happened. The animals started to come. The Bible says that God brought the animals, God called them. And here they are coming onto the ark in their pairs. So the ark had one door, you see, the door that Noah made, and the animals were coming into it, into the ark. And after that, Noah and his family went into the ark. So we had Noah and his wife and his three sons and their wives. How many altogether? Yes, 8. So they're all on the ark and they were waiting. Did anybody else come into the ark? No. Noah had told lots of people, but they didn't listen. They didn't listen to God's warning through Noah. You know, boys and girls, this reminds me of before I was a Christian. And I used to go to a club on a Friday night called the Shell Club. And it was really good. We got to play lots of fun games. There was a tuck shop. It was brilliant. I used to get pocket money and be able to buy sweets. But at the end of every night, there was a little talk, a bit like what we have in SML. And at the end of the year, there was a weekend. And I went away on this weekend. It was actually to Port Stewart. And the man speaking at that weekend, I remember very clearly one of his talks. And he was speaking on a verse from the last book in the Bible. Do you know what the last book in the Bible is? Revelation. So this story that we're hearing about today from Noah, it's from the first book of the Bible. What's that? Genesis. But in Revelation, God said in Revelation chapter 3, verse 20, I stand at the door and knock, and anybody who opens the door, I will come in. And the man who was speaking, he had a little picture of a door, but it was a very unusual door because there was no handle on the outside. There was only a handle on the inside. And he explained that this door was like the door to your heart and that Jesus was standing at the door knocking. But it was up to me to make the decision to open that door to let him in. And boys and girls, it's the same for you. There is only one way, just like there was only one door in the ark, there was only one way for us to be saved. There was only one way for the people to get onto the ark. It's not enough to be good. It's not enough to listen to SML or to go to SML before lockdown. So it's not enough to go to BB or GA. You have got to come and put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ to turn away from all the wrong in your life and to ask him to save you. And so that is what I did, but I didn't know that I could do it there and then. Do you know you're sitting right where you are now in your living room or in your bedroom listening to this? You can ask God into your life now if you've never done that. You don't have to put it off. I waited until I was back at home and then I asked God into my life. I said, Jesus, thank you for dying for me, and I want you to come and forgive me for all the wrong that I've done. And since then, Jesus has been living in my heart, and God's Holy Spirit has been with me, helping me. So all the animals came, Noah and his family went under the ark, and they waited 7 days, and then something happened. I'm sure they looked up at the sky, maybe grey clouds were gathering, and they were starting to get a little worried. Maybe Noah wasn't such a fool, maybe God really had told him that. Drip, drip, started to rain, heavier and heavier, and then it started to pour with rain, and the people started to run over to the ark. And I'm sure they hammered on the door and they said, "No, we're sorry, we should have listened, let us in." But it was too late, because the Bible says that God closed the door of the ark. Noah and his family were safe inside, and everybody else hadn't listened, and now they were going to be lost in the flood. God had given them a chance and they had ignored it. The rain came down for 40 days, and the Bible says the rain came down and the waters from the earth came up, and the ark was floating, and Noah and his family were inside the ark for nearly a year. Now, you know, we were in lockdown, we were inside, we couldn't really go outside for over a month. Can you imagine being inside for a year? Boys and girls, God is faithful, and God did not forget about Noah and his family. And after 150 days, after the 40 days, you can do your maths, the water started to go down and down and down, until eventually the ark came to rest on a mountain. Noah sent out, first of all, a raven, and then he sent out a dove, but he waited patiently for God to say, and eventually God said, "Noah, it's time for you to come out of the ark." And Noah and his family came out of the ark, and they said, "Thank you to God." Boys and girls, today is the last SML of the year, and you know, I am saying thank you to God. Thank you, God, for helping us through the whole year, and especially in these last week when it's been strange, hasn't it? We haven't been in the church building, but that we still be able to meet an SML like this. I said thank you to God. And every time when we see the rainbow, we remember how God said he will never flood the world again, but also we'll remember lockdown, and we'll remember how God helped us all through it. Do you remember we said that there were two of every animal, and then there were seven pairs of some? That was because in those days before Jesus, to say thank you, they made a sacrifice and burnt it. And so you can see it here saying thank you to God. God had kept Noah and his family safe. And boys and girls, if you love God, you'd be very certain that even though you might have to go through a storm like Noah when he was on the ark, God will never leave you. Remember, I will never leave you. And you can put your name in there. Boys and girls, thank you for joining with us today and through the last number of weeks. And we will see you hopefully soon. Take care. Bye.
Hi, boys and girls. I hope you listened well to the story. So I was thinking about the story, and I was thinking about Noah's Ark and how long it took Noah to build this Ark and all that he needed to make it and how big it was. So I was thinking about what we had within the house that we could make Noah's Ark. I'm sure your mums and dads have maybe had a few packages delivered. So I was reading through all our cardboard and was able to come up with this. Now, I think it's impressive. Everybody else in the house laughs at my Noah's Ark, though I'm not quite so sure it would float. So the other thing that I thought of was that maybe you have lots of Lego around the house. And I know in our household, Olivia loves to play with her Lego, and we were able, maybe you could try and make an ark out of your Lego. And then I also then was thinking, if you have a recycling bin, maybe you could have a rummage around in your recycling bin and see if you could build an ark or a boat and see whether or not it would float or not. So I came up with this. I know it doesn't necessarily look like an ark, but I thought we could try and put it in some water and see if it would float. So I have two bottles and a bit of cardboard, so it's floating. And then I have two dogs, so I'm going to put them into our ark and see if they're going to float. Do you reckon they're going to float? Soon find out. So, and don't forget, Noah had two of every animal. Whoop, whoop. There we are. We have an ark or a boat with two animals in it that floats. So maybe you could have lots of fun trying to build an ark, whether with some of the stuff that you have in the house. Even you could use hammer beads if you have hammer beads as well. Hope you have fun. Bye.